I can create transfer orders either manually or from my planning worksheets. And if I want to create them from my planning worksheet, I need to set up planning parameters for that. So first of all, let's take this scenario here. I've made a sales order. We'll just find the sales order here. And the sales order is defined for whatever customer, and I want to sell a quantity of city bikes on location simple 2. And I don't have any inventory on location simple 2. So one way of getting the inventory there, because it's all on simple 1, is to create a manual transfer order. I can do that directly manually here. I'll just show that quickly. Going into the transfer orders, pressing new, saying what location code I want to transfer from and what location code I would like to transfer to. And if I have not defined a transfer routing for this combination, I will get an error now, but I did. The item number and the quantity. So here I can post if I want to. I could post my transfer order, shipping, and afterwards receiving, and that will move my item from one location to the other. If I didn't want to use a transfer order for this, I could just use an inventory journal or item reclassification journal to move it. But in this case, I can get a document, and it's possible for me to print out picking documents, etc., for my warehouse. So I will just delete this again to show you how it works with the planning. So to run the planning, I need to do some setup. I need to use stock keeping units, because from a normal item cart, I cannot set up a transfer as a replenishment method. But in the stock keeping unit, that is planning per location, per item, per variant, it's possible. So here on item 1000, I've made a stock keeping unit on location simple 2, meaning how would I like to replenish my location simple 2 on this item. And I can also see here that my quantity on sales order is 10, of course. And if I go to my replenishment, I can define a replenishment system as being transfer. Whereas on the item card, I only can select the other three. So transfer, and I need to say from which location will I default fill up this location. So normally if I'm transferring from simple 1 to simple 2, this is the correct setup. And I need to set up, of course, correct planning parameters that we show in many other videos. So right now I'm ready to go to my planning worksheet. In here, I can calculate my plan. And in this scenario, I will just filter on both item number 1000 and location 2, not to get too many lines in here. Location simple 2. So I'm planning on the simple 2 location, and it figures out we need this item. It suggests a new order. And as you can see here, the quantity of 15, and it's a transfer order. So here I can just check mark this one and carry out action message, and that will create a transfer order for me if I have selected here make transfer orders. And I can also combine, if I have many lines, I can combine the same combination of locations on the same transfer order. The line is now deleted and my transfer order is created, and it's in here.